Ready? This is CP Algebra 1, worksheet number 2 from chapter 3, Odd Problems Worked Out. Problem number 1 says, determine whether the relation is a function and explain. So again, remember we're looking at our input, which are our x's, so we have a repeat of the 8s and the 4s, so that's no. Number 3, let's determine if this is a function. So if I draw any vertical lines, I can only touch a dot once, so yes. So my domain doesn't repeat, that my x values don't repeat. Number 5, again, if we take any vertical lines drawn through, it only touches each point once, so yes, that's a function because the domain doesn't repeat, the x values don't repeat. Number 7, the function y equals 7x plus 35 represents the monthly cost in dollars of group members. Joining fitness club, identify the independent and dependent variable. So the dependent is the cost, which is our y. Our independent is our x, which is the number of members. Your group has enough money for 6 members to join a fitness club. Find the domain and range. Okay, so you can have anywhere from 0 to 6 people join this club. So that would be our domain. In order to find the range, we need to plug those values in. If I plug 0 into my original equation, I'm going to get y equals 35. So that's the bottom part of my domain. That's going to be a square bracket, or the bottom part of my range, excuse me. So you're paying a minimum of $35 no matter what. And then if you plug 6 in, you get 42 plus 35, because 7 times 6. So if you add those up, that's going to give me 77. So it looks like you can spend between $35 and $77. That's your range. Number 9 is talking about an Uber cost you $2.50 a surcharge plus $1.10 for each mile driven. What equation would represent this? So you're going to spend $1.10 for every mile, and we'll call miles X, and you're going to pay $2.50 just to call the Uber. Okay, if how much would it cost you to drive 5 miles? So if you plug 5 in for X, that's $5.50 plus $2.50 because your surcharge. So that's going to give you $8. How far can you travel if you only have $19? Well, then I'm going to take 19 and put it in for Y and solve for that. I'm going to subtract 250 from both sides, so that's going to give me 1650 equals 110X. Let me just double check on a calculator, just make sure all my math is going right. Minus 250. Again, it's 1650, like we said, and we're going to divide that by 1.10. So it looks like I can go 15 miles if I only have $19. And what is the maximum amount of money if you spend? If you have 19 to spend, determine the domain and range. So you're going to spend, what is the minimum amount of money you will spend if you have 19 to spend, determine the domain range. So it looks like you can spend from 0 to 19. You spend 250 to 19 because you're calling the Uber. And then that's your domain, your range. If you had plugged those values in, looks like you could have went 0 miles to, 15 miles. So there's your range.